Morfugu News Entertainment, radicalizing his followers.
Exactly.
And I don't want any doxing or anything to defamatory. I think that's awful.
Exactly, guys. That's what I've been trying to stress to. I've been telling you guys, but I've been stressing it to the clown that started all this. You have to go back 6 months. And then, because 6 months ago is when I became a YouTuber. And then you got to go back before I became a YouTuber. And it was UniRock exposing Morfugu. UniRock exposed them, okay? And UniRock is good at it. UniRock don't ever make stuff up about someone. UniRock keeps it real. He does real reporting and real journalism. And when he spots a fraud in the YouTube community, he's blowing your cover, bro. Did it to Morfugu. Morfugu called and cried. Next thing you know, I don't even know UniRock yet. I'm exposing Morfugu on a live stream. Morfugu calls in. It's still up. Morfugu calls in, crying. He made a fake report. Shauna, right here on the screen, Shauna will tell you, Morfugu lied and said that he was being harassed and his kids were being threatened and that he put pictures of his little girl in Discord and on Facebook and pretended it like he had a sock account to do it. And pretended like it was someone else harassing him and threatening his daughter. Because this is what Morfugu did. And he did it the day I exposed him. So he calls in and he tries to make it like I'm the one doing that. I said, bro, listen, you're sitting there trying to make him feel bad. But don't ever, ever accuse me of nothing with women and children. I'm not with none of that. I said, is that what you're saying to me? This is on the live stream. Morfugu answers me back and says, I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying. And all his audience was in there trying to see it. Dude, the first couple videos I made, I just wish I gave the proof better then because the videos went boom. They skyrocketed. I'm talking 5,000 views in one day. So if I'd have had my proof, I kept telling people, you gotta give me time because there was just so much shit about this dude. You guys don't know. I'm telling you. You don't know how much shit I got out. Oh, everyone in here. Everyone over there. Everyone that exposes Morfugu, you have no idea how much shit they got on him, but they don't show. Because some stuff you just don't want to show. You try to be respectful, even though he's a scumbag. You try to look at it like, as a human, should I do that? Or, hey, they might take my channel down. Or maybe you look at it like, if it's cop-related, anything to get him in trouble with the police, I'm not going to do that. You know what I mean? I'm not going to show something about him that's going to get him in trouble with the cops. I'm just not going to do that. You're never going to have me call cops and shit. You know, he threatened to bring me to court and shit. Morf, I dare you to try to bring us to court. Because, yeah, me and Sean is us now. And same with Princess, same with Ivana, Kim, Heather, all the girls that you victimized, all the females that you abused verbally, threatened, harassed, and then sent trolls on them to bully a girl, Morph? You're a clown, cuz. You're a clown. You can't even bully the girl by yourself. That's the best part. You can send somebody to bully a girl. I mean, it'd be bad enough if you was bullying them. But you send somebody? You're that much of a yo-yo coward? Guys, I'm telling you, the dude is a coward. Give me some time. And if I get motivated to really do it, and I pull up the old videos and then throw a little collage in what UniRock had and what I had and then what Marf said, we caught him in so many lies. First, he deals with a Q channel. He takes money from a Q channel. He goes on UniRock and says, no, I never took money from, what was the dude's name? Dustin? Whatever the dude's name was. I don't care. He told UniRock on live stream, I never took money. 2 months later, I'm exposing him. He's on my live stream. I said, well, you took money from a Q channel, and then you act like you don't, you know, Q's bullshit. You don't mess with Q. Q's a psyop. You act like that, but why you take money from him? He said, he admitted it right there. So what? I took a $3,000 loan and paid it back. We don't know if he paid it back. All we know is that he took money from a Q channel. What the big deal is that he was against Q at the time. At the time. Now, you guys don't get it, man. It ain't been around. He changed his game. He's an actor, bro. That's all Marfoo Gwiz is, an actor, okay? So if you like watching him, understand he's an actor. What you're seeing most of the time is an actor that ain't real. Well, no. You're always seeing an actor that ain't real, but most of the time now, he's playing the mainstream shit, so either or, that's bullshit too. That's exactly what he is. He's a mainstream YouTuber. Mainstream news on YouTube is Marfoo Gwiz. So if that's what you like, cool. But just understand, though, you have to understand. This is our point we're trying to get across, is that we don't want other, because of him being a fake truther, we don't want to be looked at sideways from other people because Marfoo Gwiz is a fake truther. And he acts like he believes in stuff that he really don't believe in. That's the big deal, guys. Okay? And not to mention all the females he harassed. But when I expose frauds, that's where I'm coming from. You can't sit here and share the same beliefs as me, but you're pretending, and I'm for real. Dude, it's the same thing as someone being in your crew, okay? Just because we don't all get along don't matter. Just picture someone being in your crew. Say you got a little crew, okay? And then someone in the crew is doing something real fluey. Say someone in the... Oh, I can't say that. No, I can't say that, okay? See, I'm in prison. We got the crew. And say we find out one of the dudes in the crew is gay? But you can't do that. You make us all look bad. So you gotta go. You have to go, bro. Or say we're in a crew, right? And it's all white boys. And say somebody says something to one of our boys. And he says, you're a bitch, bro. I'll smash you. And say, dude, don't do nothing back. You can't do that. Because you make us all look bad. Do you understand? And those were just examples. Understand that, YT, okay? This is an example. But do you guys understand where I'm coming from now, okay? This lady is a good woman. She's facing it fearless right now, and I love it. That's why I dig it. That's why I got her back. You know what I mean? She's a married woman with, I'm not sure she has kids. She got pets. You know what I mean? Nice little house wherever she's at. She don't deserve that, man. She don't deserve that. No, none of you do. Ivana, you don't deserve to be harassed, okay? And then back 6 months ago, Heather and Kim and the other girls that never didn't want to show nothing or talk. Dude, listen. He had girls so scared that they wouldn't call in my stream and say they were scared of him. They said, nah. They thought he was a serial. You get what I'm saying? That's the tendencies that dude got. Be careful when you're watching. That's all I want you guys to do. Go ahead and watch, dude. Just be careful and understand. You have to take it with a grain of salt. Most of what he's saying is lies and fake, okay? Just like he's pushing the EMP shield, okay? Notice, watch. Marf is going to keep talking about blackouts because he's trying to sell an EMP shield, okay? Yeah, that's marketing. That's how you market, no doubt. But guess what? This ain't fucking marketing, Marf. This is truth. Okay, we're searching for truth. That little dumbass EMP shield ain't gonna help no one if they pull the switch, cuz. Don't play dumb with me. That EMP shield ain't doing nothing but electromagnetic pulse. You think that's gonna block it? Yeah, that's for very little outages.
Does no one else care? Is everyone alright with that? Like, what am I really involved with right now? Who are the people that I'm acquainted with as a truther community type dude? It's embarrassing, bro. It's embarrassing. So look, if you're a YouTuber, I'm still cool with you, man. Look, we're cool, bro. But if you don't make a video sticking up for these people, man, look, I don't want you to share me. You don't gotta share me. You don't gotta mention me. If you just don't make a video showing and talking about that they called Shauna's mother and put it on a live stream cussing out an old lady, then they called me and put my whole government out there. My whole government, which means my address, all that stuff goes out there. Then they call Red Pill's work, get him piss tested, which he passed, by the way. Then they talk about his wife who has cancer. And Amanda, I'm sorry, Amanda. I don't, listen, you've been in my prayers since I learned about you. I apologize, Amanda. I don't want to put your stuff out there. Red Pill, I'm sorry. I'm just saying. He is talking about someone's wife who has cancer and his daughter. Are you okay with that? Look yourself in the mirror right now. really turn, go look in the fucking mirror and tell, and say, am I okay with knowing that I know Mark Fugle and I watch him and that he has gave people permission to put people's families out there at risk and danger, call people's mom and cuss them out, cuss out someone's cancer wife that is sick and their daughter? Go look in the mirror and ask yourself that. And I just want you to know that if you turn around and go like this, I don't want to get involved. It's not my fight. I don't respect you. I do not respect that. Yeah, we're still cool. It's still all love. But I just need to you to know that I don't respect you, man. I do not respect that. What is wrong with everyone, man? Let's go, man. Let's go. Either share this or make a video, guys. All right? If you're a YouTuber and you don't feel like making a video, then share this one. Okay? Just to tell everyone. It needs... Okay. Here is the angle, man. That if Mark Fugle News would just go like this, all he had to do, man, listen. All Marf had to do was say, listen, guys, don't ever do that again. Or it would have never happened in the first place if he didn't give the green light. Trust me. This is all because of Mark Fugle TV. But afterwards, all you got to do is say, you go publicly apologize. And don't ever do that again. That's all Mark Fugle had to do. But no, this has been going on for days. People's family members are getting called now. People's lives are getting put in jeopardy and at danger. You know, my freedom is at risk here. I'm not necessarily worried about my life. I'm worried about my freedom. Because I'm going to defend myself and my family at all costs and by any means necessary. I don't care about going back to jail when it comes to that. You understand? Do you get what I'm saying? I don't want to, man. But I'm going to defend my sisters and any other family member I got in this neighborhood, by all means necessary. So they're putting my freedom at line. But forget me. I'm the least important here. You got Shauna with her mom, her address getting put out there. They doxed her phone number. Stick up for her, okay? Share this or say something for her. Okay, you don't want to do that? What about the five other girls that have been? Jume, gotcha. Crystal, all these girls. Kelly, you know what I mean? Teaching us about the love bombing, the cult personality, and the love bombing they've been doing on people. We got their whole playbook.
Snafu was on that phone call when I was told that I could not call the FBI. Boy, my case was squelched quick. And I called the FBI because I got a phone call that I was going to have my abdomen sliced open. This is going to be graphic, so hold your ears and move the children. This is what I was told. Trying to get me in line. Trying to get me to obey and follow the channel rules. That my abdomen would be sliced open. That my bowels would fall out at my feet. That I would be so stunned when it happened that I would take a step toward the person to try to get a hold of them, and I would trip over my own bowels, and I would fall, and when I fell, that they would take my own bowels and wrap around my neck and finish me off and choke me to death. That's the phone call that I got explicitly explaining my death.
So when you hear Shauna in this video, you know, earlier, this was the start of her just leaving the channel. It wasn't till months later that her mother and father's lives would be threatened as well. Now, I don't know all the details of that. I'm looking to get them, but some things are a little bit, you know, sensitive. But Shauna's family, her parents' lives were threatened. So the attacks on Shauna didn't go on that long because she was in fear of her parents' lives. And these are not the only two people that had their lives threatened. I've heard of others. So, you know, I know that WV has asked not to have her video displayed, but it is on her own channel and her community page, I think, or she might have put it up in her videos, and you can go see it there. But, you know, she doesn't wanted out because of a process she's going through with a child, but to stop me from using it in my videos, she has to copyright claim it. And in order to copyright claim it, she has to put it on her channel. So it doesn't make no sense, WV. It doesn't make any sense. You don't want me to play any part of the video that you posted up, that you called me and told me. You got me started on this venture. You got me started in all of this, WV. And I love you for that. I love you for telling me the truth. WV, I'm not doing any of this to hurt you, sweetheart. I am not. But you have to understand what these people have done to a lot of us. And you do understand that. So I don't know why all of a sudden you've changed. Because it isn't for the reason you said. If it was, you wouldn't worry about no copyright claim. You would have, because you have to put the video on your channel in full to do any copyright claim at all. And to put the entire video for little clips that I'm going to put into mine doesn't make any sense at all. You could have called me. You did not call me three times. I'm sorry, but you did not. I do not, I've already explained in my very first video the trauma I had when my son went to Iraq, first three tours. I don't answer my phone unless I see who's calling, unless I see a name. And your name comes up when you call, and your name never came up. My little guy, he runs to the phone. I do not. My mom gets, not anymore, but she, because she doesn't call as often, but for many years, she would get so mad because I wouldn't just go get the phone. I'd tell her the phone frightens me. I'm very traumatized by the phone. So I do not run and jump when the phone rings. Matter of fact, I cringe and do not want to even acknowledge it, but I know I do need a phone here. So my little guy will run over and tell me who it is. And then when we go to the store and come home, that's the first thing he does because he wants to see if his grandma called him. Or his auntie called him. So you never called me. But even if you did, I'm not trying to call you a liar. Even if you did and we missed that, why didn't you email me and say, hey, I'm trying to call you. Give me a buzz. Why didn't you do that? Because I was never avoiding you. I love talking to you. I adore you. I love the advice that you gave me about my Christopher, my older boy with the, you know, with the brain trauma. I do adore you, WV. I'm not doing this to hurt you. My last video was stern, but I'm a grown woman just as yourself. I am 58 years old, just like, well, I think I'm 59 now, just like you. All right, Jeremy just said I'm 60. I'm a grown woman just like you. And now that I am no longer part of any of that garbage and I'm exposing it, I will not have anybody tell me what I will and will not post, just as you. You need to respect that as I do respect you. Now, you could have called me and yeah, we could have talked and I could have said, okay, I'll only do it during this time or that time or whatever. We could have worked it out. But to do a video attacking my child, to do a video saying you're going to expose something that is not a dirty little secret at all. And it's not yours to tell, even if it was, for you to say the things that you said in your video. Just to take it down? Why would you do that and make a video like that and then take it down? Because you know what you did was wrong. It was wrong, WV. What these people have done to us is horrible. It's horrific. What they did to you was horrible, WV. It was horrible to hear that conversation. It's disgusting. Those people belong in jail. No, I'm so sorry that my video upset you enough that you felt you had to do a video about it. But I think if you had listened to it, calmed down and listened to it a few more times, you would have heard my passion. You would have heard what I was really trying to say. I wasn't trying to hurt you or go against you. I'm going to tell the truth of what these people did. And I'm going to use videos that I need to bring that truth out so other people don't get hurt. So, WV, I know you said in your video, don't call you, don't text, blah, 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 and all that. I get that. So, I was going to call you after your video, but I thought, leave her alone. She's angry right now. Just leave her alone. But then that night, you went into mine, and you were, you know, putting messages in there, in my video. So, I deleted them, and I blocked you from my channel. Now, I will unblock you. If you would like to talk on the phone, I would love to talk with you. This isn't about me and you against each other, WV, at all. This is about them and what they've done to people. They threatened Shauna's parents' lives. Why do you think Shauna shut up and went away? She was in fear for her own family. They were taking letters and putting them in envelopes around her neighborhood, saying horrible things about them so that all the neighbors could read it. Who had money to do that? Not Adam, but Dex did. Adam has it now. But at the time, Dex had the money to do that, to pay people to do things like that. You know that. So WV, I'm not trying to be disrespectful to you. I adore you. I love talking to you. You made a comment that I didn't answer the phone because I didn't want to get on a phone call with you and homegrown about God. Are you kidding me? That first night we talked for 4 hours about God. I tried emailing homegrown a couple of times, asking him to call me because I love his take. I love that he goes outside the Bible and we cooperate each other on what we're learning. No, you don't, because you don't go outside the Bible. And I wish you would, but hey, so it is what it is. But I loved talking with homegrown because he does go outside the Bible, because he does learn new things. And he understood that I do too. Whether or not what I learned is right or not or true or not, it's all information. That's all it is. And I'd rather have it than not. But to try and throw whether I read the Bible or not, WV, what I said to you was that I don't read the Bible. I've never read it front to back. No, but I do read it. Not, I don't sit here every night like some people might do, but I read a lot of other books. And then I go back to that every now and again. But am I faithful to it? Do I sit here and read it every night? No, I do not. And I probably should. But I was raised in church from infancy all the way up to 16 years old. And at 16, my parents sent me and my foster brother to a church camp in the Colorado Rockies. And after 2 weeks there, I came home and my mom said, I taught you about God. It's up to you to keep it going. So to tell me that I don't know anything about the Father, I know more than most people, because most people are just jumping on the train right now. I don't know a lot, but I can tell you this. I know enough to know that those books they took out, we're allowed to go and read. Because the Father would not have put in there not to add or take away, because he knew they would. So you can attack my beliefs. You can say whatever you want about any of that, but it doesn't matter. I know what I know. I know who I am, and I don't need to defend myself against that. And the whole thing about what happened in the garden, honey, you cannot just take it out of context like that. You need to tell the whole story. But I will do that. Don't worry about it. I'll take care of that. I want to do that in another video and explain to people what you meant, because the way you made it sound, well, you know what? It was almost as bad as the phone call you got. Well, it was worse than the phone call you got, actually, but I'm going to share that with people. I'm going to show them where I got it. But WV, if you've calmed down and you would like to talk to me, I'd love to talk to you. So I will go and unblock you. And, let's just see where it goes from there. And I do love you, WV, and I'm very thankful for everything you've told me. I am very thankful.
Why don't you make a video and stick up for them, or share this for them? Or here, how about this? How about Red Pill? How about his wife? How about his kid? That they could his kid. Yeah, no. They screamed at his kid, saying F your kid and F your wife on the phone. Oh no, he got it recorded. Okay, so why don't you just defend them then, okay? Because Marfugal TV could have said don't do that and it would have never happened. But here's the better picture. Here's the bigger picture of all this. Now, Marf denies everything. I can't control what people do. Don't you understand? He gave them websites to do this. Dex and Marf paid these two dudes to do this. I cannot believe Marf has done. Marf, I would never ever put your family in danger, bro. Do you understand? Every time I showed your record of beating women and that child, I blocked your address out. I blocked your last name, blocked your date of birth. No. I blocked your last name and your address every time. I never doxed not one of you, okay? You start calling Shauna's mom and I showed her something on the news. That's all I did. you called Shauna's mom and aired it on live stream. So get the picture, okay? Don't do shit like that. That's not cool. That's not okay to be involved in people's families, alright? That cussed out Shauna's mom, called somebody's work, cussed out someone's wife and daughter. Okay, and guess what? If you was associated with me and you did something like that to defend me, I would publicly come on here and say, you're a disgrace to me. I don't condone you going after women and children. I don't condone you calling someone's work. You don't do that under my name. You don't do that defending me. I'm telling you that right now. You do not do that and be associated with me. I will not be associated with anybody that does something like that to someone's family. I will not be associated with anybody. And did Marv come forward and say that? No. Case dismissed.
And you see him. Where's he at? Look at him. Look at him hiding by. Come on, Marv. Marfugel, come on from behind the curtain, man. Come on. Snafu's over there. Snafu don't want to be your mole, Marfugel. Snafu Cracks ain't trying to be your little mole to come on here and bully females, okay? Now, don't worry. This ain't even about Marv. I just want to show you that the danger of putting out propaganda and fake news, okay? Because just remember what I'm about to show you. These people, these networks, these companies, this business, this company and corporation of fake news, okay? The mainstream side of it, they started at Marfugel's level of fake news, okay? And if you haven't seen the exposure of the hot musket, the fake domestic terror report that Marfugel made up, he had a fake soldier call in, a whole pretending. Shauna was the assistant already with him for months. Like I said, Shauna's the one that blew his channel up, but they got rid of her because they got greedy. They didn't want to pay her, probably. I bet she did. This is not Shauna's words. This is just what I assume that Marfugel got greedy with Dex. Dex was hating on Shauna, so Dex probably wanted Shauna out the way, and Marfugel went with Dex, and then they betrayed her because they probably didn't want to pay her. They're just being greedy. They're greedy people. These are not good people you're dealing with over on Marfugel. They're completely different off the screen. Don't worry, I'm working on something to put everything together for you guys so you could just see it all in one glimpse from the last 6 months, all the way back to Hot Musket. Working on something. Yeah, I shouldn't even tell. I shouldn't put my ideas out there like that, but guess what? It's already there, you know what I mean? He can't really stop it. The only thing he could do now is change and come clean with everybody. You know, Morph, if you come clean with everybody, you're not going to lose your subscribers. They're not all going to go away. You might lose some, but guess what? You'll get more respect if you just come clean and be honest, Morph. And if you tell them to stop bullying Shauna. I'm sick of you with your years of domestic violence abuse against women and kids. I'm sick of you harassing women. These are girls. No, I'm not no saint. No, I fight with my girlfriends. I've called my girlfriends names, bad ignorant names before. I've disrespected females. Yes, no doubt. But like I said, like my girlfriend, I watched my mother get disrespected growing up. I just don't like seeing a girl get bullied. I'm never going to just stand there. If I'm walking down the street and you start beating your girlfriend up in front of me, I'm getting involved. Don't put your hands on a girl in front of me. That's what I've never done. I never will do. I can say the words never because I'm absolutely positive I would never, ever raise my hand to a girl. Yeah, I disrespected a couple of my girlfriends, mainly everyone. Almost everyone I got into a bad fight with and said, F you, bitch, something like that. Yeah, we all get mad and make mistakes. I get it. But as for the random female that I might see in the street or walk by, no, I don't. I love women, okay? This man, Marfugel, hates women, okay? He hates women. He has a history of it. Go ahead and look up my criminal record. You won't find one domestic violence. If you find any violence on there, that's because I was charged with a robbery and I was charged with a carjacking. Here's the key words. I was charged with it. I was acquitted in the court of law. I have paperwork to prove that. I was acquitted for mine. I was innocently charged. Had to prove my innocence after over a year of sitting in jail fighting. And I did. I proved my innocence on both violent cases I've ever had. I proved my innocence and I beat them. I was acquitted in trial. Every other charge on my record is drug related. Drug dealing, drug using, drug this, that, and the third. Just drugs, okay? Stupid drugs. I hate them. Forget it. This dude has a... My history of drug charges doesn't even... Ain't even as long as his history of just beating up women and hitting a kid. Okay, so this is the danger of someone like Marfugel putting all this fake news out and propaganda. Because as you know, propaganda is now legal in the United States, okay? Someone at Marfugel's level, though, I'm not sure they're really allowed to. But I'm not calling police or nothing. I'm just proving it to you guys. And like I said, Mar, if you come clean, you tell the truth about everything. If you could tell the truth about Hot Musket and everything you did with Shauna and tell everyone to stop, I will stop, bro. I will stop. I'm not looking to take your channel. I'm not looking for none of that. All these connections you lie about, you got CIA connections. It's all a lie, bro. You're a liar. And then you got people really scared of you when you would never, ever put fear in me. You can bring that shit on to me. All them threats you sent me 6 months ago when I did this, still follow through with it. Go ahead. I'm not threatening you at all. I'm telling you, just come clean, man. You claim you're a Christian. You was never a Christian in your life. But if you really are a Christian now, then you will come clean. You'll forgive everyone. Everyone forgives you. I'll forgive you. Everyone can forgive me. I'm not, okay? I'm trying to be level-headed with this. Anyway, this is the danger of someone putting out fake news. And this is why everything I do, I tell the truth about. I give my true beliefs and opinions on it. I never made anything up, and I never will, because of shit like this right here. Okay, guys, watch. Thank you for coming. Iggy MB 5679. Wow. Watch. Quick, send in the victims, he said, in a different language. That's what it looks like. Fake bombing.
So, for those of you that don't know, this is Iggy. And Iggy started doing these over 3 years ago, and he disappeared just over a year ago, something like that. I'm not really sure the dates, but it's been over a year that he just stopped everything, just went away. And what happened to him? Where did he go? He has amazing content on his channel, and besides all this, you know, Marfugel BS, but what happened to him? He should be proud of what he's accomplished here. But back then, not many people knew about him or was watching his channel from the Marfugel group. So I'm exposing what he had tried to expose back then, 3 years ago, when Shauna was being attacked.
Lift up the gates, fling wide the doors, the King of Glory's coming. Hey! Through city streets and living hearts, we see His spirits moving. Now His kingdom comes. mind, and now's the time. Get ready, church, let's rise up. Hey! And now his kingdom comes, now his will be done. Lift up your banners and practice your praise. Fill up your mouths with that glorious name. Jesus, warrior Jesus. Is the Lord's and all its fullness, and the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the waters. Who may ascend the hill of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul to an idol nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is Jacob, the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, Lord. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, lift up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Who touched my clothes? Thou seest a multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou who touched me?
Master, I have suffered an issue of blood. 12 years, and I knew if I could just touch thy clothes that I would be whole.
Daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace.
and behold of thy plague.
Rabbi, I beseech thee. My little daughter lieth at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay thy hands on her. She may be healed. She shall live.
Take me to your home. Talitha Kumar, arise. Tell no man what was done in this house this day. Let her be given something to eat.
Life has brought me to